two of these smaller ones will fit into a bigger one. Love it.
Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry. I help you stop living in chaos, one organized space at a time. Today we are going upstairs to my extra bedroom. Well, it was my son's bedroom since he's adulting now on the East Coast. I turned it into my YouTube studio / long-term prepper pantry. Now, I've had this set up for a few months, but I'm finally able to show you or give you a tour. It's not completely to what I want, but it's pretty close. So I'm excited to share it with you.
All right, so I'm in my home office / YouTube room / guest room / workroom. So we just call it the workroom. And here to the right are the double doors. I will put a link to the previous video where I showed like the before. And so this is after, but still a work in progress. Okay, let's start here to the left. And they're just sliding doors. Probably have to wipe that down. Okay, so here you go. On the left side are the canned goods. Up here are, you could see more like boxed items, fig bars, and some of the cheddar biscuit mix, and some mashed potatoes. And these are all my Augustin Farms. I did a video on that, link that also. And what I did was to just put shelves that hook onto the walls. So I put two of those shelves. And then I had started this closet with a 2-week prepper pantry. And of course, people there said, oh no, that's 2 months worth. Whatever month's worth it is or week's worth it is, just start prepping, find a space. I chose to put a use this closet. My son is now an adult, so this was his room. So I do have this space. But instead of clothes or more knickknacks and stuff that we don't use, I decided to use this for a prepper pantry. Okay, so with that 2-week beginner prepper pantry, I'll link that video, I have these shelves that I got from Walmart. And I think I bought a third shelf, but I'm not using it, but I needed it for this shelf itself. And because these are just $25, and so it was a lot easier for me just to go ahead and get the two extra shelves from that and use them here versus going to, let's say, one of those Home Depot or whatever, get it cut, and then it wouldn't be the same color. So I knew that would kind of bother me a little bit. And you could see that it's bowing just a little bit, or maybe you don't, but that's something to think about. I might put a little stick underneath there in the middle to just hold it up, but it's holding fine. Okay, so you can see the things that I still need to stock up on. We definitely use a lot of tomato sauce for different, what's that called? Different recipes, chili, spaghetti, things that we use often, some other Filipino food dishes that I make. And these are mason jars that are vacuum sealed, or, you know, with the little machine. And so you see we have beans, some crackers, oatmeal, some rice, some lentils, and definitely this works because I have those crackers from however 3 years, 2 years old, and they're still yummy and crunchy. And then as far as tomatoes, I like to have sliced, stewed, diced, sauce, sometimes crushed. And these jars have more like pasta. You can see more lentils, cereal. I think this is kind of a random sugar, but I'm working on storing more sugar. Okay, and then these crates I actually got from the Container Store, but you can get any crate. You can even get the ones that are collapsible. So I just have these, and I just wanted white crates versus black or red or whatever. And I have here extra oil that is from our stock up oil from Costco. And you see some ramen. These ramen packets are from Walmart. And I have a lot of soup things. So when you find something that you like to eat, go ahead and get them. So these I got, you can see this from Ross. I've also gotten from Walmart some of the ready-made soups. And then here you have the canned beans. So just, you know, like how they organize in a grocery store, they're a perfect example. If you're not sure, just look. So they have all the beans in one place and then all the soup. And we definitely go through the beans, so those are good. And you could put the dates on top of the can, or you could put it in front, whatever works for you. One thing I realized was that I really just don't like canned soup. And so I'm trying to finish this up, but it's really hard. But obviously, if it was an emergency situation, I would definitely eat these soups. But what I'm planning to do once these are gone, I'm going to either add more beans, add more of the seafood or the meat. And you saw that in my other video that I have some in my extended pantry, which is in my laundry room. But I just want to add more, like more of the maybe chicken and some other things, okay? So let me know in the comments below what you think I should do for soup. I was thinking of dehydrating vegetables and things like that for a soup and, you know, vacuum sealing that. And then we would just add water or broth. And here to my left, this is my favorite spot. Oh, we have some Worcestershire sauce, A1 Tabasco. These I get on Amazon. They're just the right height for the, you know, the vertical space of between the two shelves, which works out because this is the right size. Because sometimes you buy things in bulk and they're just like humongous or they're too heavy and you may think you're saving money and or, you know, or whatever you're saving. And yeah, that works for you. But for me to get as far as like where I'm going to put everything, you know, the overall plan of everything, I decided to go ahead and get the smaller bottles, and this fits perfectly and the price is fine with me. So you can see right offhand. So I usually have all three of these in my cabinet downstairs with my spices and sauces, but I have these as backstock. So four of them backstock is fine. Then you have some applesauce, and then you see here turkey gravy. Those are good things to buy when, you know, they go on sale. Here's some sloppy joe sauce, salmon, and then some pasta stuff. So this I like, you know, this was decent. I think this was from the Dollar Tree, and I think this was from the Dollar Tree also. And then we have cream of mushroom soup. And then these containers are from the Container Store. I think it's Acro, A-K-R-O. These are not necessarily cheap, but look at, they're so sturdy. I love these containers, but you can get any kind of container. The goal here is try to make it two levels, because if it was just one level, there'd be a lot of vertical space here that is underutilized. Same thing here with this crate. You know, I knew the oil is this big. I wanted it contained in these crates, but there's still space here, and that's where I could fit the ramen. So here's just some seasoning. Most of it is from the Dollar Tree. So seasoning, you can see I can stock up some more soon. And here I just have chocolate, because when chocolate goes on sale, I like to just grab. And this is kind of like our secret stash. And some more seasoning, can't have enough seasoning. And this is a great shelf. This is the fruit and shelf, these two. Okay, then it goes down to other stuff like veggies. So one thing I also notice is that I'm trying to get the same size can. So some are, you know, obviously larger as far as diameter, some are wider, you know, some are skinnier. So you just try to buy the same, whether it's the brand or same size can, that kind of helps with keeping it organized and tidy. And of course, just like in any grocery store, you can see the labels facing forward. So pears, pineapple, mango slices, I get those from the Dollar Tree. Fruit cocktail, red grapefruit, love it. Okay, peaches. Then we have corn, love all different types of corn, but usually I do a lot of the whole kernel, but you can get like sweet cream. And then here, potatoes, these, I've just always been debating if I should continue to get these, but I think if I just have one row, then that will be fine. And you can see deep, it's like three deep. Okay, peas, definitely use these. Mixed veggies, I use them, not as regular food, but definitely want to keep it there for emergencies. And I do find ways, let's say like a pot pie, I will use these so that I can use them up. You got sliced carrots there, French style green beans, and cabbage. And these, you know, I used to be really into them, and I get them because they're easy. And if my kids are here, it's something that they can eat. My kids mean my adult kids, right? Something they can eat. My husband will not touch this, but it's something, remember, it's stuff you can eat, or that you store what you eat, eat what you store. But also, you know, in emergency situations, it's just easier to heat that up, or you could eat it straight out of the can. You know, it's not a gourmet meal, but it's going to fill your stomach, right? Okay, then there's chili, and then we have here fruit stuff for like pies. Okay, and if you stand back, you can kind of see what this looks like. So I feel like you can see everything. It's categorized well enough, and I can see the things that I need to add. All right. It's definitely a big difference from just a two-week pantry or even just the before. And then, so it's nice, you know, it's behind closed doors. So it keeps it tidy even that way, in case when I'm opening the right side. And here, just kind of have an overview. So more Augustin Farm. So Augustin Farm fills this whole space here. I got the larger ones there. You could see rice and rice, because rice is life. And then these are like the kind of pack, you know, it becomes like a whole meal. So it's a 4-person kit. Get these from Walmart. They're a great price. So 4 of them fit, stacking up. It goes all the way to the ceiling, so I'm using up all this space. And then here, the great thing with Augustin Farms is that it's color-coded, which I love, so it's easy to see what I need. So example, I need more drinks. Those are drinks. I need more dairy. And so it's 4 up, okay, and 2 deep, so 8 cans each. That's a great start. Now, you know, the space isn't like humongous, but there's a lot of food that you can store here, especially when you get these types of number 10 cans, okay? So here you see grains, baking, fruit, veggies, entrees, and then some ready-made, you know, like it's already chicken Alfredo or something, or Alfredo like that, and then meat. So I will do a stock up of Augustin Farm, so I'll go through that more in detail when I do that video. Okay, here, so I just have some random containers that I've always had for pasta. You can see that I need to fill those up. These containers I got from the container store, and the reason I got them was I had this little space and I needed something stackable. Okay, I did have things that, like, let's say it goes up to here, but it wasn't stackable. You can have things like this. This is from IKEA. Fantastic. I used to use these in my freezer organization. But these are great. And some of them will have handles. And then they fit into each other. Okay, so let me try to show you one of these containers. Okay, so you see how 2 of these smaller ones will fit into a bigger one. Love it. I mean, you don't have to get from the container store, but think of that type of, you know, keeping it organized and tidy. Organized is, you know, basically a system. So I know, like, the ones in these are example, like, overflow canned goods, because I ran out of categories here. So here are some more meat and seafood mix. Okay, and it worked out that it fits the cans perfectly. Okay. And then, yeah, here are some more, I think, Indian spices. Yeah, by the way, I kept these open because, as I was saying earlier, I don't know if I'm going to dehydrate vegetables and put them here. All right, time to put these back. And you can go on Amazon to get stuff like that, but that's not necessary, you know. I just had it here because it's just an extra. Hold on. I used to have those containers in my regular pantry, but now I'm organizing it differently. And so I just said, instead of giving it away, I just keep it here for now. So you see in these IKEA containers, and I've labeled it in the front so it's easy to see. Okay, some more trail mix there. Pudding. Indian spices. Okay, a lot of space. Okay, coffee, tea. And then, because what I wanted, the reason I labeled, did you notice this? I labeled on top and in the front. So when I'm looking at it from here, I label because you don't have to use your brain too much, right? You just say, oh, Indian spices versus what was in here again? Okay, so Indian spices, I put it here in the front. And then when I'm looking above, I can see it from above also. twice you're helping your brain not to work too hard. Seasonings. So those are more the bigger ones. Okay, basmati, couscous, paella rice. Okay, and then you see what I did here? This was kind of bowing in a little bit, so I just put the tops of jar lids there to give it, because it was going here, but that just reinforces it. It's great. Okay, then I have salt. And so salt, there are just like bags of salt. It's not like just salt decanted in there. All right, then I just got more oil in here, some more chicken. These are just kind of random. This is a different type of oil. And then this is the tote that I have in my extended pantry that I highly recommend. And then you see that I've just stacked up the coconut oil. These are some sample things that I think was sent to me. And now the 5-gallon bucket. So what I did was I just went on my computer, printed these out, and just wanted them really simple. But of course, the word also, because you know, if you just see this, you may not know what it is. So baking, and then a bag. You see here veggies with a carrot, rice with a bowl of rice, pasta with some noodles, oatmeal in the oatmeal jar, some more oatmeal there, more pasta, more rice. Okay, so I need two hands, hold on. Okay, so what I've done with these, some of them are just boxes and others are prepared, you know, where you vacuum seal it. And others, you could put the Mylar bag and put all the rice in there, or you just put all the rice direct, or you can have boxes of pasta. These can be more dehydrated veggies. All right, then I also angled these labels so that I could kind of see it from here versus it being turned around facing over there. You don't remember what it is. So this is breakfast, so that could be pancake mix, and here's some powdered milk, sugar, and then this is, let me see if I can reach in there and show you, that's flour. And same thing with these 5-gallon buckets. You could see the labels are facing forward, so when I open the door, it's just right there. If you want to see more videos on how to organize your preps and the rest of your home, click the next video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.